Well, let's stay with nature, and native oysters are a highly endangered species across Europe. But in the River Fal in Cornwall, they're keeping a traditional fishery alive.
More than 20 boats dredge for native oysters during the winter months from October to March using ancient methods. And our reporter Grace Pascoe is live at Pendennis Point for us this evening. You've been out dredging today. Tell us more about the methods being used.
Yeah, that's right. So you mentioned it a little bit, but the methods are really traditional. So you can't use an engine if you want to dredge for oysters in these waters. Instead, you can row using oars or sail using the wind. So it's really traditional and weather dependent. And as you mentioned, it's a winter fishery. So I was lucky and had a weather window. So I found the experience really enjoyable, but they obviously have a lot of wet and windy weather. There are lots of threats facing the industry, as I've been finding out. Slipping through the waters of the River Fal, Chris Ranger sorts through his catch, something he's done aboard the Alf Smithers for the last 11 years.
It's a way of working, it's a way of life. It's on the river, it's not staring at a computer screen, it's not sitting on the motorway. It's all of these things that, you know, make it enjoyable to do. It's the possibility of it that's probably the most exciting.
Oystermen like Chris have been fishing on the Carrick Roads and surrounding rivers on these vessels for centuries, and the industry is still governed by some ancient laws put in place to protect the oyster stocks, including fishing under sail using the wind and tides, and also using these traditional hand dredges. But Chris believes more needs to be done to keep this industry going well into the future.
The management is probably the biggest threat. Oysters don't swim off. If we leave them, they grow. If I put one back and someone else picks it up, that's bad working processes. If we all worked together, had areas we didn't fish, areas we put the small ones in, then I think the population of oysters would increase. We could then have a bigger minimum landing size. We can supply restaurants with top quality product direct rather than selling it to another fishery for them to grow on and for them to have the, you know, the economic benefits.
And the rope will just go.
Yep. Ooh.
Native oysters face threats big and small, including competitors for their space on the seabed.
We are concerned about the levels of Pacific oysters that are showing up. So just a few years ago, they were very rare. I did a survey in 2012 and found no Pacific oysters in an area now where you would find thousands. It's been a really alarming increase in population of these non-native oysters. And there are concerns that these could have an impact on the environment and potentially also the oyster fishery in the long term. There's many different threats, you know, climate change. And on top of that, we've got the fact that there's water quality issues, particularly in areas that are becoming more developed.
Some in the industry have concerns about who will fish for oysters here in the future.
The guys are getting older. Demands for very high-priced property, and it's made it real tough for young people to come in and sustain living in Cornwall. We've got a big gap of young people coming in.
At present, the majority of the oysters caught here are exported to France.
It is a shame that so much of our seafood gets exported, and actually it should be being utilised here in Cornwall. It's on our doorstep, it's low carbon, it's sustainable food. You should be eating local, and we'd encourage chefs and the public to have a go and to taste local delicacies like our fal oysters, you know, fal queen scallops and all of the other amazing sustainable seafood that we have on offer.
Many believe if the demand increased locally for these delicacies, then the industry would have a bright future. Grace Pascoe, ITV News, Falmouth.